I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting.
How you doing, Mikey?
Good, thanks.
So, what's your walking around weight? Just so I can conceptualize an Errol Spence fight.
Natural 150, 152 is average for me. We don't really gain a whole lot of weight, you know. Uh-huh. It's just natural weight. And as soon as we start working out, you know, weight starts to drop. Pretty comfortable. We pick up the intensity and strengthen the diet a little bit more, and you know, we cut down, but it's not that challenging.
Have you been following Robert Easter on social media, Instagram, or Kevin Cunningham?
Not quite.
Seems like he's giving it. He's giving like everything into this fight.
Well, he should. I mean, it's a big fight, not just for myself, but I'm sure it's probably the biggest fight for him, or at least that's what he's expecting. And I think that's great. That shows me that he's excited, motivated, and hungry. And you're gonna see the best Robert Easter on July 28th.
How about the reach? You know, you've got 8 inches of reach advantage. I'm sure that you've been preparing for that, obviously.
I don't know exact numbers. I haven't really paid attention, but I know he's very tall and has longer reach.
What does that open up? I mean, obviously that's an advantage for him, but what does that open up for you?
Well, I think in the gym, I'm already working with different sparring partners who work on different things and make the adjustments. Either I catch him reaching in, or I have to, you know, put pressure and work my way inside. You know, there's gonna be different things that I'm capable of doing. You know, like I said, I'll make those adjustments. But I'm pretty experienced already fighting taller guys in the past, so I don't feel that it's a huge disadvantage. It's a disadvantage on paper, but once it comes to fight night, you know, I'll be ready.
You've got some body punching opportunities for a guy that tall too.
The natural, you know, thing is to probably work the body. That's what, you know, theory says, but I'm not a big body puncher naturally. I will be working the body if the opportunity is there, but that's not like the only game plan that I'm trying to hold to. You know, I like I said, I have a lot of things that I can do, and I'll be prepared to do whatever it takes.
Mikey, obviously the top rank stuff ended. You've been very active. You're 30 years old now, kind of in the prime of your career. How much emphasis is there to kind of remain active during these prime years, and what are you maybe hoping to accomplish over the next couple
of
years?
I think I'm in my prime right now. I feel, you know, in the best shape. I feel in best shape physically. You know, I'm mentally, you know, in the best, you know, shape also. Very strong mentally. So I'm very happy with the way things are going for me. I do want to stay active. I think I need to take advantage of the moment right now. Take on the biggest fights available. Give the fans fights to remember, give fights that people can talk about and be excited for. I want to keep fighting, you know, champions. I want to keep fighting big fights. Those are the fights that excite me the most.
Is this Spence thing like a real thing that you're considering?
No one believes me, but when it happens, you know, you guys are going to be surprised. I'm very serious. I really would love that fight. I'm not looking, you know, past Robert Easter, but, you know, if everything goes well and we're not, you know, injured or anything like that, the other fight that excites me would be a Errol Spence fight. And the challenges that he presents are so great that that's what motivates me the most.
How much would it take? What would the process be like to get to 147 comfortably?
Well, I just gotta change the training a little bit more. Gotta change the diet a little bit. I wouldn't be really cutting weight. I'd just be maintaining a natural weight, which I think is gonna be fine for me. But we do gotta change the training a little bit so that I can adjust to that size, you know, the welterweight division.
How did the fight at 140 kind of, I don't know, affect your thinking in regards to a Spence fight? It looked like you were fighting a guy who you were a lot better than maybe technically, but again, the strength kept him in the fight.
I can feel the size advantages, the size difference. Two fights at 140 against Adrian Broner and against Sergey Lipinets. Those fights, although we were at 140 on weighing, you know, fight night, they were a lot heavier. I was probably about 47, 48 on fight night. They were probably 155 or close to 160, because I could just feel the size, I could see it. But I still have the abilities to fight and overcome that size disadvantage, that strength. So with Errol Spence, a little different, because he's also very talented. Technically, he's very, very talented, great fighter, and he still has that size and weight advantage. But that's what excites me, because everybody says no, all you guys think it's a joke, and I'm gonna do it.
You talk about being at your peak right now. How do you think you're a better fighter now than you were before the year and a half, 2 year layoff?
I'm hungrier, I'm more motivated, I'm more experienced, I'm in a happier place. And if you're happy and you enjoy what you're doing, then you do it, you know, that much better. So I'm very happy. I think this stage of my career is the one that people will remember most. You know?
How much longer do you want to, you know, again, not that...
You know, I don't have a specific, you know, time, like number of fights or years or age that I want to retire.
So there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, at Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram, at Elie Seckbach.